the edge, don't wanna push me. You better check where you step, don't wanna cross me, no, no. They try to wrestle me down, but I'm the bigger man.
All right, so I hope the audio here is pretty decent, guys. If it's not, I do apologize. Bit of a different setup than my normal talking head videos. But that's for good reason, because a lot of you guys have been asking for a living room setup, and that's what we're doing today. Now, as we get closer to the setup, or to the living room, you can see that it's not that big, and honestly, it's nothing too crazy, but you guys want it. The only, you know, outrageous thing is this huge, massive, 135-inch fixed projector screen. Now, like I said, my place is pretty small, so as I go over to the couch, you're gonna see that, it's honestly not that far away. I'm sitting maybe 10 feet away, and that just means that it's immersive as hell. Closest thing that I can get to the movie theater experience. And one of the reasons why I went with this screen is because it does give off movie theater vibes. This is the same type of screen that they use up in the movie theaters. This one in particular, I'll link it down in the description below, but it's from Elite Screens. And what I love about it is that it's under $250. If you start looking around for fixed projector screens, then you're gonna see that they go for like five, six, seven, sometimes a grand. Nobody's got that kind of money. So, this is a metal frame, pain in the ass to put together, but once it's up there, it looks beautiful and it complements any projector really nicely. Just below that, if you guys wanna come closer, you'll see that we have a sound bar. Now, thing looks tiny in comparison to this massive screen. But, you know, I live in an apartment. I can't have, you know, a subwoofer and all crazy home theater, you know, speakers. So I went with this one. Now, again, I don't know the model number. I know it's Cohen. They should call it the e-cigarette. It kind of looks like an e-cigarette. But puts out pretty decent sound. I can't be too mad with it. You know, it's much better than the projector audio. Just to the left of the screen, we have one of two shelves. Now, this shelf right here is just housing all my pop figures. I don't have a whole lot at the moment. I'm really only trying to collect for TV shows or movies or characters that I really, really like. Now, on this top shelf, we have my Big Mouth collection. There's only four right now that I know of. We got Nick, the Hormone Monster, Hormone Monstrous, and Andrew. Now, if you haven't seen this show, guys, you need to go watch it, especially if you dig like Family Guy, American Dad, even Rick and Morty, things like that, adult cartoons. This one is up there on the top of my list. I absolutely love it. Now, on this second shelf, we have some Crash Bandicoot Pops and some Gizmo and Gremlin Pops or vinyl figurines. But these were some of my favorite characters growing up, man. Gremlins, awesome movie, man. If you grew up in the 90s, then you know just how iconic that movie is. It's so great. Crash Bandicoot, what can I say? People still love that game. It's awesome. Below that, again, just some favorite characters from my childhood, man. Hey Arnold was the shit growing up. I absolutely love it, so I, you know, I had to pick me up those. And then the Flash and Superman, I don't really care about too much, but I got a good deal on it, so I can't complain. Over here is a much more interesting shelf. So like I said, over here is a much more interesting shelf. We have like my PS3 collection, which I'm starting to collect more for now that the games are so cheap. I think for all those games over there, I might have like over 80. I only paid maybe around $60-$70. So I look out for good deals and I start collecting for that. And we have a lot of awesome titles here. I mean, so many just good games. We have like the Arkham series. It was so good. Assassin's Creed Black Flag, the BioShock series, Borderlands. So many just nostalgic good games that I, you know, had so much fun playing. God of War, the whole God of War collections, Ascensions, God of War 3. Kane and Lynch, awesome game if you haven't played it. Midnight Club, Uncharted series, man. Skate 3, so many good games. And we also have, if you want to get closer, we have my puny little Nintendo Switch collection. I know my games are looking pretty weak. I'm trying to build up a collection. My most recent pickup, though, is Dead Cells. Now, if you guys haven't played Dead Cells, check it out, man. I'm just addicted to that game. I should be putting out more videos, but I haven't because of that. And then we also just have some figurines, some collectibles, again, from the PS3. I'm starting to collect more for it, like I said, because it's so cheap. Tomb Raider, Batman, Max Payne, The Order 1886. Awesome stuff. Now, behind the couch, we just have some LEDs to give off that chill vibe. And up here is three of my favorite TV shows, and they all match, which is cool. Better Call Saul, great show. Haven't even finished it, but I'm loving it so far. And then everybody knows Breaking Bad, one of the top shows, man. It's just so good. The story, everything, the ending, nothing about it is horrible. And Dexter, my favorite show of all time. Ending kind of sucks, though. But these are all on, like, these snap frames, so if I want to swap those down, I just snap them. They're screwed into the wall. They look really nice. They're flush. If you get up on the side, you'll be able to see. Matching cushions on the couch to match those. Posters, but, yeah, if I'm being honest, that's about it. Like I said, my living room's not too insane, man. It's nothing crazy except for that huge projector screen. But you know what? I don't care. I enjoy it. It's a small space. You got to work with what you have. And I absolutely love kicking back here, playing games, watching movies, Netflix, and chilling. You know how it is. As always, everything that I talked about will be listed down in that description below. Let me know what you guys think of the living room setup, though. And if you enjoyed the video, you already know what to do. Give me a thumbs up. Drop me a comment. I love hearing from you. If you disliked the video, hit that dislike button twice. Let me know what I could have done differently. If you haven't yet, check out some other content. Consider subscribing. I'd appreciate it greatly. I'm signing off. Catch you guys in the next one.